I've had my DJI Mavic 3 for a while now, and I've had a chance to test out all the features in different scenarios and come up with my initial review. So here are the things I like about the drone and some things I don't, the good and the bad. So we can't talk about the DJI Mavic 3 without starting with video quality. And I just have to say that 5.1K footage is incredible. When you get it right, when you frame a shot right, when the weather looks great, the sun comes out, image quality is exceptional. And you really notice that improvement on a big screen. When I was looking at the previews of the video on my phone, I was thumbing back through and looking at some of the Mini 2 footage, and I was thinking, it's an improvement, but I'm not mind blowing. And then I got home and put it on the computer screen, and my mind was blown. The detail, the quality, it's everything you would expect from a drone of this price point, to be quite honest. When you buy a drone at this price point, you have an expectation of video quality, and this probably beats it. It is phenomenal. In normal mode, the colors are very, very good. The Hasselblad Natural Color Solution, which I thought was marketing speech, brilliant. The normal profile in this drone, perfect. The colors you get from it need such little tweaking. I mean, yes, if you want to apply a creative look, that's something completely different. But if you want beautiful looking footage, you can basically take the footage straight from the drone and it looks amazing. The Hasselblad Natural Color Solution, whatever they're calling it, it works. The colors that come out of this drone in normal mode are bang on. I do wish in the app we could tweak it a little bit. So in the Mavic 2, you could change the sharpness, saturation, and contrast. I do find the image that comes out of the drone in normal mode a tiny bit too sharp. So I wish you could adjust that in the app settings. You can obviously do it in posts, so it's not a big deal, but we could do it in the Mavic 2. We could change them settings. So I'd love to see that brought in for the Mavic 3, just to dial back the sharpness a touch. Everyone else I think is perfect. Now, D-Log mode. I personally have struggled with D-Log mode a fair bit in this drone. I find it to be very hard to bring the colors back to something that looks normal in post. I find the D-Log image to be incredibly flat. I mean, really flat. I know it's supposed to be flat, but it is so flat. Just, I personally can't bring the colors back to anything that looks pleasing to my eye. And compared to the colors you get from normal mode, if you do like a back-to-back comparison of D-Log and then a normal profile that comes out of the drone, I can't bring the image to look anything like the normal profile, let alone better. But I'm actually not that disheartened, because normal profile is so flipping good with this drone. I personally don't see a need to use D-Log. Even in shots where you do have quite a bit of dynamic range, normal mode works so well and the shots are so good, I just find leaving it in normal to work absolutely fantastic. So that's my personal experience with D-Log. I find it pretty much impossible to use, but again, that's probably my skills. But normal mode in this drone produces such exceptional footage, it doesn't really matter to me personally. 4K 120fps mode in this drone is dreamy. It gives you so much creative possibilities, especially in an area like Northern Ireland where you have a lot of coast. Getting shots of really dramatic waves in slow motion looks amazing. And if you pair that with really high speed movement when you're recording, when you play it back, that slow motion just gives you a really interesting and cinematic shot. The creative possibilities that 120 FPS at 4K gives you in this drone, again, is incredible. And I personally haven't had any issues with the jerky or stuttery footage that some people are reporting online. Some people are saying they have issues with kind of stuttery shots, or it looks like it's dropping frames. I've had none of that. The shots I get are perfectly smooth, I'm happy to report. Let's talk about performance, and I have to start with that 46 minutes flight time. It's really noticeable. We're kind of, as drone pilots, ingrained into knowing roughly when the battery's getting down to a low point. You kind of know in your mind, mentally, when that point in time comes, so you kind of get a feeling of, okay, I've been flying for this amount of time, surely I need to bring the drone back to change the battery now. And that still happens with the DJI Mavic 3, but when you look down, you realize you've got like 60% of your battery still left. It's incredible. It gives you so much more time to set up a shot and frame a shot just to make it perfect. The Mavic 3 has 35% less drag than its predecessors, and it's lighter. And I've got to tell you, you notice it when flying. I know it's only a few miles per hour quicker than the DJI Mavic 2, but it feels so quick in the air. When it's in sport mode, you can get it into position so quick, and it just flies beautifully. I've flown it in quite windy scenarios because the wind's quite heavy around the coast here at the minute, and it's so stable. You put it up in the air and you think this drone's gonna get blown about a bit, and you know what? It is rock steady in the air. So let's talk about safety, because no one wants to crash a drone, let alone a mortgage with propellers, let's be honest. So you want to make sure that the safety features work really well. So how have I found them? The Mavic 3 features advanced safety systems with improved obstacle sensing sensors and navigation systems and a new tracking system. It has omnidirectional sensors, so it can sense all around it, and that just makes flying your drone a much safer experience. I haven't been in too many scenarios, I have to say, with this drone yet, like in a forest, for example, where there's a real risk of colliding with something. I normally nip that in the bud and don't really fly in them scenarios. So I can't personally say that I've been in a situation where the drone has yet had to kick in to stop itself crashing into something. But from looking at the videos online and from knowing how well DJI does obstacle avoidance, I feel very secure in the knowledge that I'd have to probably go out of my way to crash this drone. So those are the things I love about the drone. Video quality, second to none. If you want the best camera in the sky right now, you gotta get the DJI Mavic 3. If you wanna be blown away by the footage you can record with your drone in the normal mode, it has to be said, get the DJI Mavic 3. Now for a few things I don't like, and some of them are quite nitpicky. One of them, not so much. The first is the missing features. It has to be said, I know everyone's saying it online, I know they're coming in January, but I have the drone now and I would have liked the features. So there are quite a few features missing from this drone that are due to be added with a firmware update in January. And the first is ActiveTrack 5.0. And it's not that this drone doesn't have the latest version of ActiveTrack, it doesn't have any ActiveTrack. So the biggest thing about ActiveTrack 5.0 that I'm looking forward to is that the drone has the capability of losing sight of whatever it's tracking and will continue to fly intelligently until it picks that subject back up. So the Skydio 2 is probably the best tracking drone available right now. And that's something that drone was capable of. It could lose sight of you very quickly, but it would fly and it would continue to fly until it picked you up again, and then it would continue tracking you. And that's not something that was possible in any DJI drone yet. What would happen is the drone would lose sight of you and it would stop. So with Active Tracking 5.0, the drone can briefly lose sight of you, it can continue flying, and it can pick you up again. And this is great. This is great for scenarios such as cycling through a forest, which they showed in their advertisement trailer. But the problem is at the minute, the drone has no active tracking, and I want to do active tracking. So I'm slightly annoyed that there's no active tracking on it yet. We also don't have quick shots. So that mode that allows your drone to do maneuvers such as the helix for you automatically, you know, you've got the droney, the rocket, the boomerang, they're all missing from the DJI Mavic 3 as it stands. We don't have master shots either. So that's that mode where you could select a subject, hit go, and your drone would go off and record up to 10 different cinematic shots with framed on you, and it would come back and you'd have a cinematic piece of footage all done for you. That's currently not available on the Mavic 3. We don't have panorama mode for photos, and we don't have quick transfer. Not so heartbroken about the quick transfer because it's not really a feature I use, but I am a little bit annoyed that there's no active tracking yet. If it means they're holding off to make sure it's the most exceptional active tracking possible, then I can wait a month or two for it. The next thing I'm not a huge fan of, and this is really nitpicky, and it doesn't take away from the drone at all, is the gimbal protector. Every time I take it off and put it on, I just get the feeling it could be simpler. And look, it works. It protects the gimbal, it holds the props in, it does its job, but it just feels like a little bit of a faff. When we look at something like the DJI Mini 2, you get two items. You get your gimbal protector, which is a nice little plastic cover which goes over the gimbal, and then we get our prop guard, and you can put this on or you can choose not to put this on. And both feel well thought out, they feel well molded and easy to put on. With the DJI Mavic 3, the gimbal protector and prop guard are one. It's a bit of a faff to put on. I would have much preferred it if there was a plastic gimbal protector for the gimbal itself, and then an optional prop guard, you know, just a simple band that could go around the props to hold them together. I'm not as big a fan of it being one piece. It works and it does its job, and that's just me being nitpicky, so bear that in mind. And as I say, it's a gimbal protector. It's not going to take away from your drone experience. So am I happy with my purchase? Well, it's worth mentioning I bought this drone with my own money, so I feel like I'm entitled to let you know how I feel about my purchase based on the amount of money I spent on it and my expectations. And the answer is yes, I'm super happy with this DJI Mavic 3. It exceeds expectations in a number of areas. The video quality with that normal picture profile exceeds my expectations of what is possible with a camera in the sky. The footage is mind-blowing. In terms of performance and reliability and flight time, again, the drone exceeds expectations. It is beautiful to fly. The extra flight time is phenomenal. It gives me so much more time when I'm in the air. Now look, that's not to say that this is the drone for every scenario. There are a few situations I'll still use my DJI Mini 2. If I'm going out in a hurry just to get a couple of quick shots, I'm just going to grab the Mini 2 for convenience. If I'm going traveling and want the lightest drone that can still give me exceptional footage, I'm going to take the Mini 2. But if I'm going out somewhere where I have the time to frame a shot, or if I'm going out to a super epic location and I want to get the best quality shot possible, no compromise, then you're obviously going to reach for the DJI Mavic 3. So my initial review is, super happy with my purchase. Looking forward to the missing features being added in, and can't wait to get this guy out and get even more footage with him. There's so many things with this drone I'm yet to try out, such as low light to see what the quality is like, and I want to really put that slow motion through its paces and see the kind of creative shots I can get with it. Now, before you go, do you want to know the biggest drone mistakes new pilots make and how to avoid them? Then you're going to want to click up here. This video goes over 15 of the biggest mistakes new pilots make with the DJI Mavic 3 and other drones, and I'm going to see you over there so that you don't make them mistakes the next time you go flying.